All right, this one's called Bertha Von Nation. Well, I didn't even say that right. All right, this one's called Bertha Von Nation. Bertha Von Nation. It's like a German thing. I shouldn't get wrapped up explaining the titles. Of all the terrible, nasty, and sensitive shit I write, nothing gets folks more riled up than my fat girl stories. Whenever I get negative feedback of people's feelings being hurt or businesses no longer wanting me to leave the magazine on the premises, more often than not, there's a fat girl story behind it. Now, I don't know if it's because I immerse myself in fat women and their culture, therefore I'm overexposed to their opinions, or if the shit I write about them really is more offensive than everything else. The outrage and sadness I've caused aren't even what bothers me. What bothers me is that somewhere along the way, a message has been misinterpreted and people come away thinking that I'm anti-fat girl. Nothing can be further from the truth. I've been fucking fat girls throughout my entire sexual life, okay? The first girl I ever had sex with was this fucking monster truck that I worked with at Albertsons when I was 16 years old. She used her two front wheels to ring shit up on the cash register like Speed Buggy from the Hanna-Barbera cartoons. Although it seemed a bit odd at the time, this particular encounter pretty much became par for the course as far as my sexual liaisons go. First of all, there was no courtship or romantic exchange whatsoever. Just an inappropriate comment like, "I'll sack your groceries" or some shit, followed by her calling my bluff with, "Oh yeah? Well, how about right after work?" And next thing I know, we get in her car and she drives me around the back of the store, thus ending my virginity and beginning the big game hunt that is my sex life. A lot of odd things happened to me that night, the least of which was seeing a truck drive a car. During the hasty ordeal, I was on top of homegirl face to face in her back seat, and she told me to call her a slut. I don't know if I'd even ever call the girl a slut at that point in my life, much less right to her face, and certainly not at her own behest. I was like, "Pardon me?" And she screamed, "I said call me a fucking slut!" And reluctantly, I tell her, you're a slut? This wasn't near good enough. I was like, "Call me a slut like you fucking mean it!" I stepped it up a little bit, and I was like, "You're a slut!" Still not good. "Say it! Say it, fucking slut!" I got a little braver, like, "You're a fucking slut." And I never got used to doing this, but at one point it crossed my mind how funny it would have been to take things up a notch and just go, "You're a fat fucking slut," but I didn't actually say that out loud. The thought of it crossing my mind was enough to make me start giggling uncontrollably. And this didn't go over well at all. Apparently, just because a girl gets off when you're calling her a slut doesn't mean she likes being laughed at. And she dug her fingernails into me and tightened up her pussy. And I seriously felt her pussy tighten up on my dick like a noose. And I assumed that all girls could just do that, but I had never noticed because I'd never gotten laid before. She's got this crazy look on her face. "Don't laugh." She sounded like a fucking demon. Well, this rattled me a bit. Actually, the whole thing rattled me. It was my first time. The bitch was crazy. She made me call her a slut and almost beat me up. The whole while, I'm trying to convince myself I'm out riding Bird Dog and Bigfoot. When we're all finished up, she's driving me around in my car, and she looks at me all sideways and just goes, "Well, look at little Chad. Just got him a piece of ass. You think you're hot shit now, don't you? Don't you?" She had this terrible hatred in her voice. Up until that point, I had no idea that lovers treated one another like this. One thing you have to realize is that, sexually speaking, I'm quite the commodity. I'm ruggedly handsome, smart, mysterious, funny, creative, a humorist, a singer, a performer, a movie star, a radio personality, a publishing magnet. I got a dick like a fucking bowling pin. Basically everything every girl wants all wrapped up into one man. And believe me when I tell you that countless hundreds of women, and even a few men I thought were women or wanted to think were women, have agreed with me on this in the most certain of terms. What I'm trying to say, as humbly as possible, is that I'm pretty much a sex symbol and could seduce any woman I wanted to, but I needn't bother because they throw themselves at me in droves. Now, have I been mean and only fucked the fine ones? Have I been finicky or judgmental? No, I've been quite generous to women of all walks of life, especially the fat ones. I've fucked more pigs than Kermit the Frog, yet somehow this is construed as me being insensitive. Why? I mean, you don't see beautiful women going out of their way to fuck big fat guys, do you? If one did, then even the fat guy would have to agree that it was pretty goddamn nice of her. I'd like to harken back to a question I posed in print several years ago And again, wonder if fags ever just fuck fat dudes on purpose so they can laugh about it with their friends? Or is that strictly a heterosexual shortcoming? Anyway, point is, I feel like I put in enough time down on the fat farm for my good intentions to be apparent. And I'm not going to go beyond just simply recounting to you my exploits. I'm going to tell you why I think you should fuck fat girls too. And then I'm going to recount to you some more of my exploits. All right, first of all, it's a challenge. Go for it. Live strong. Sure, anybody can pound the shit out of a small, fine-ass woman. But why don't you try fucking on someone your own size for once? Unless you're gay or just a really little guy, then you're not going to get the opportunity to fuck someone bigger than you all that often if you don't specifically go after large prey. It takes an entirely different sexual skill set to pleasure a woman upwards of 250 pounds. You have to be able to grapple, you need to know pressure points and submission holds, and your floor game must be completely developed. Ultimate fucking, ladies and gentlemen. I haven't even mentioned the mental focus and concentration required to stay hard through one of these events. Now you're in bed with some beautiful, hot young slut, and your dick practically stays hard on its own, with no requirements or thoughts of emotion whatsoever. It takes an extreme mastery of mind over matter to stay up through 15 rounds with a heavyweight or two. Now you notice I said heavyweight or two. That's because fat girls fuck like they eat, in herds. Once a woman reaches a certain weight threshold, she pretty much enters into an implied contract with the guys who'll fuck her. It stipulates he gets to fuck all her friends too, given that they're of equal or comparable size. This leads to an attitude that'll have you out on a date with a couple of porcine beauties repeating the phrase, "If I fuck this, then I better get to fuck that," over and over in your head like a mantra. You'll often get into a situation where you'll be courting a group of big women, but they actually have a skinny, fine friend who hangs out with the pod in order to look good by comparison. I usually refer to this girl as the quarterback. I'm gonna go ahead and expand on the scenario for a bit because it leads to an interesting conundrum. In theory, you might be able to fuck the quarterback someday, but in order to do this, you'll have to resist the temptation of fucking all her friends because that'll bring issues about your pickiness into question. Now my advice is just go ahead and fuck the big girls because there's safety in numbers and chances are at least one of them is going to end up being a sexier lady than the skinny girl anyway. Plus, if you're a sex god man, as I've been personally referred to in the throes of passion, and you do a really good job of fucking the offensive line, then you might get through for a sack after all because good news travels fast, even by sonar. I'm compelled to harken back to one time when a couple of land animals picked me up. It was the typical, if I fuck this, then I better get the fuck that scenario that I described earlier. It's amazing how one woman can be so fucking big. She can make her friend, who's pushing 20 stone as it is, seem like a fine little chickadee. Anyway, these two just took me to a hotel room and totally worked me over. They basically dressed my dick up like Richard Simmons. Or seriously, they put a leg warmer and a headband on it, and I just started sweating the oldies. And when we were all done, I went and took a shower, because that's how I keep from getting AIDS. And I was washing my hair and shit, so I had my eyes closed and was just replaying the night's events in my mind. And the phrase wildebeest sandwich popped into my head, and I started laughing out loud to myself. Out loud, I just go, "Oh shit, wildebeest sandwich," right as I'm opening my eyes. And one of the girls, the smaller one, is just standing there on the other side of the clear plastic shower curtain, marveling over my body. I didn't mention this before, but this girl was ate up with a terrible case of dumbass. So she didn't even know what the fuck I was talking about. She just kept staring at me with this dreamy smile on her face. I ended up crashing out there in the room. And I woke up in the middle of the night between the two of them, and they were both just snoring so fucking loud I couldn't believe it. It reminded me of being in jail, because most of my stays in jail have been in this barracks-type environment with 20 or 30 other guys. I'd always wake up in the middle of the night to this John Wesley Harden situation with all these motherfuckers snoring around me. But anyway, that's what it reminded me of. It still hadn't stopped me from bringing a gaff when I go to the bars, though. When I sat down to write this, I knew I couldn't do an entire article making fun of fat chicks without prematurely running out of material. I couldn't help the pessimism, as hanging out with fatties can lead to a very Malthusian view of the world. It looks as though we finally reached that point. Although, I never did get to work in the part where I was going to suggest that Ozzy Osbourne wrote Killer of Giants about me. That being said, I'm signing out.